line of storms that are going to be making their way to us.
You know, that same storm system is now marching through the panhandle, and that's where we have to watch the I-10 corridor. A pretty good-looking line of showers and thunderstorms. As a matter of fact, as we enhance the satellite there for you, when you start seeing those darker shades of orange, that's when we have some pretty intense thunderstorms. We don't actually see buildings south. In fact, if anything, the tail end here appears to be weakening. But we're going to watch the trench through this corridor right through 11 o'clock to see what may come through overnight tonight. So that's one of the things we're watching right now as we continue to take a look now at that line of showers and thunderstorms. We take a look at the composite radars all around the southeastern half of the United States. That's a pretty good-looking line of showers and thunderstorms, no doubt about that. It's definitely catching this forecaster's eye. So we'll watch it. The tornado watch has expired up north. They haven't reissued it, so the thinking is that this will weaken after sunset, but we are seeing a few showers popping up out ahead of the main line. Here is Ocala. There is Bellevue. There is Reddick. We head south. We're now on I-75. A few more showers popping up over towards Wildwood. These are drifting off towards the villages, Eustis and Leesburg. A few of them may hold together. And over towards northwestern Polk County, we'll watch these showers. A few of them may affect the attractions over the next couple of hours. By the way, you can track these storms with us throughout the evening here. This is our interactive radar on WESH.com. You can see a whole slew of weather warnings and information there, and you can track this line as it continues to move southeastward into central Florida later on tonight. I'd urge you to check it out. It's a pretty neat thing. Now, temperatures late tonight, tomorrow, are going to be awfully warm out ahead of our main line, 62 Ocala, 64 Leesburg, 65 in downtown Orlando. But the timing on this in our northwestern locales, probably from about 12 a.m. to 2 a.m., then moving through the metro areas right around the morning commute. But this is a fast mover. And by 4 or 5 o'clock, this puppy is going to be offshore. By the time it's all said and done, most of us will pick up about a half an inch of rain. Then chilly and much, much cooler now Thursday night and Friday morning. So the heaviest rainfall totals definitely northwest of the metropolitan areas, but everybody should do fairly well with between about a half an inch to three quarters of an inch of rain. High temperatures tomorrow early in the morning there, so to speak. Low 70s north and west, mid 70s south and east. And for bike week, looking a little wet there on Thursday, but the rest of the upcoming weekend, phenomenal. Even a little chill in the air. Take a look at that Thursday morning forecast. Showers and storms, no doubt about that. We don't think it's going to be severe here in central Florida, but there may be a couple of claps of thunder that will wake you up. Friday morning, heading out the door. The little ones need the jackets. 50 degrees, 66 at lunchtime, 66 by the 5 o'clock commute. And then as we head into the upcoming weekend, great weekend weather. Jim and Martha, average high temperatures usually run right around 78. This weekend, Saturday and Sunday, we'll be running in the low to the mid 70s. Don't forget, you lose an hour of sleep. We spring ahead Saturday night, Sunday morning. Back to you guys.